All right, dudes and dudettes and girls and girlettes and all that good stuff. So here's my personal off-duty fishing, I don't know what to call it. Anyways, my day-to-day life video. This is it. So, just bought this Gen 2 Helix 7 Chirp SI with GPS. Shields has a discount on these right now, so I'm gonna go ahead and get this installed, but I gotta go to Shields first and get a mounting plate and bracket and other crap of that nature. Yeah, stuff that I didn't know I needed. So I need to get this on the boat because I plan on using it Sunday and it takes 24 hours for stuff to cure. So yeah, here we go. Got the puppers with me. Just leaving work, putting in those long hours to pay for all these expensive toys and habits of fishing that I got. Yeah, whoever said fishing was cheap is a liar. You can fish cheap and you can get away with it. That's a whole nother video and a whole nother discussion. But if you're doing what I'm doing, big things, it's gonna cost you some money. So, all right, see you guys at home.
They had me putting wheels on Cadillac.
Aw, man, that's just my luck. The music would cut out.
You know it's me when I come to your town.
What I ended up getting on the old Facebook, some of my buddies were telling me to drill holes and whatnot, and I understand why. They don't want my expensive fish binder, the transducer, coming off, but I just think this is newer technology. You know, they got this epoxy resin nowadays where you don't have to drill holes. They got a whole prep kit, alcohol wipes, sandpaper. I think it's pretty self-explanatory, but in case you don't know, we're gonna go all the way over this. So, you know, if somebody else has a question like I did, how do you do this? I'm gonna put this on YouTube and then people will have something to go off of where I didn't. I mean, I kind of did. There was a couple videos out there like that, but I'm gonna read all this, save it, so that way you guys don't have to, and then I'll go back over it with you guys and see what we have to do. Okay, time to unbox Helix 7 Chirp side imaging, down imaging, GPS Gen 2. La, da, 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 da. That's where I would cue in like the Jurassic Park music. Oh boy, I'm not smart enough for this stuff. Yep, yep, yep. Ooh, that's so pretty. That's a good one. All right, so I still want to use that epoxy, but I'm gonna see how this mounts to that. I'm kind of curious. If it's just screw-ins, then it'll be all right, which I think it is. I hope it is. And this, we'll go like that or something. Okay, that's weird. I don't know why they think you needed that. I really don't know why there's holes in here. I need to finish reading the rest of this. Hold on. Technically, one of the steps, I guess I don't know why I said technically, but they said to put it in really hot water. I can't tell if this water's really hot. It'll just help the flow. I don't want too much in there. Yeah, there we go. The flow, it'll warm up that stuff. You know, you ever get honey sitting on a shelf for too long, you throw it in some warm water because you can't throw it in the microwave, not epoxy. And then what you'll do is you'll take that syringe. It says you'll screw on the mixing cap. I don't know, I got everything all screwed up. Here we go. And it self mixes it. And then you fill up these holes like that, and then you just slap her on there. But first things first, before I do all that crap, I wonder where you fill up the holes instead of just, you know, like putting it wherever you want. That I don't know. Comment down below if you know why, because I don't, but I swear that's what I read, and it says to do that. Yeah, it says firmly press the plunger of the syringe, dispense the adhesive into the four threaded wells. And then it says fill until they're at least an eighth of an inch above the brim. And that just means, you know, above level. So I'm gonna do that. I got a mask off or tape off the area where this is gonna go. That'll let me know where I'm sanding. That'll also let me know where to place this little doodad, and any excess glue that would drip down would get on the tape and not on the boat. So great. Another stupid thing I got to reckon there. I don't have masking tape. I'm gonna use black tape. Got a lot of that. Whole freaking log of it. Come on. All right, so I just got done reading all the old good old instructions and whatnot. Basically, you just want to keep it 15 inches away from your motor, your propellers, it says. So, oh God, that was pretty hard. I had to turn the motor by hand, which this is kind of weird. I mean, I don't know what they, that was down. Maybe I need to lower the motor first, or the, this fucking thing.
Did I hit the bottom? What did I just hit? Rubber. I hit rubber then. Okay.
18 inches. I don't know if they mean turned as well. It's gonna be pretty close to, yeah. So, and 15 inches, I don't think this will ever get that close. So it seems like the best place for me to do it would be 4 inches away from this guy, instead of trying to remember all that. So now what you wanna do, grab your block. Don't set it on the ground and get it all dirty like I just did. You wanna find level, and awesome. And you wanna make sure, sorry, before you put this, make sure it's not gonna hit your dock, or your, what are those called? Your trailer dock wood thingies, rails, mounts, supports, whatever the heck. Anyways, so we know we're doing 4 inches. So the way I would do this is I would take my tape, I would find, 5 inches, find five. I think I made a little scuff in it. Can't tell. Looks like it's right there. Get my tape. I'm gonna use this tape to actually mark where 5 inches is, just so I know. So we're gonna go with five. So 5 inches is right there. That's 5 inches. So I'll do that. I'll figure out where level is, save you guys the headache of watching that. You wanna make this level. You don't want it like this. You don't want it like this. You don't want it like this. You want it as level as you can make it. And by level, I don't mean like level with necessarily the bottom of your boat, because this is V-shaped here. We mean level like with the water line, you know, just in general, level across. So I'll do that. I'll get it all masked out, and then I'll show you guys the next step. Okay, so I totally get why they gave you this piece. Makes so much sense now. A lot more sense anyways. So what you do is you take this, you peel the adhesive off the back of this. Well, you're not peeling the adhesive off, you're peeling the backing off to expose the adhesive. And then you put this in here, right like that. And then you'll be able to, before you put any glue or anything, you're just doing this, you put that on there. And then that'll come off when you pull this back off. This is what I think anyways. And it'll still be there, and you'll have a a jig. It's like a set jig for anyone who runs a table saw or anything like that. So it'll be set in place exactly where I need it to be, instead of, you know, like trying to guess, you know, where's level. This, you use this to make it level, and then you can pull this off. Why that's still on there, and I probably didn't explain that very good, but we'll just go ahead and start the process. Tape this off a tad bit better. I did find some masking tape, so I'll do that, and we'll just go ahead and start. Maybe you guys will understand what I mean. Come on, GoPro, stay with me. Take that piece. I took the back, the backing off. Yeah, that's right. So it's like that. Use your level. Guys, don't laugh at my level. But I should just be able to honestly go off the tape. And hopefully this is down far enough. I think it is. I don't want to go too much further down, but also... find yourself level. Just right about there. Okay, go down a ways. Still level. Okay. Am I still level? Yeah. Okay. So push that. And then, I mean, don't push hard. Because you want that adhesive to stay. Bam. See, right like that. We'll just go ahead and... and you could have sanded this first. I didn't. I probably should have. But I just wanted to get this put on there first. Okay, now that that's done, grab the sandpaper that they gave you. And you're just trying to scuff it up. You're not trying to go to bare metal. You just want to get rid of the gel coat. And it'll happen real easy. This just allows the application process to adhere to the boat a heck of a lot better. And when you just spent all this money on this boat and on this fish finder, you want to kind of do this as non-invasive as possible. And you don't want to lose your transducer. I don't. Be home. Tab's home, yay. We both work late. We're both hard workers. Proud of that girl. She works her tail off. She actually helped me buy my fish finder. I'm a pretty freaking lucky guy. I should have just bought it myself, honestly. But she knows I'm trying to pay this boat off as soon as possible. She just got a good bonus from work. And that's what she wanted to do with her money. That's awesome. I'm extremely thankful. She's my biggest supporter. And I couldn't do it without her. So treat them right, boys. Treat them right. I got a honeydew list about a mile long. I better get on that. We got carpet coming to be installed. And she asked me to get that process going. And you know what I said? Yes, ma'am. Now go one direction with your alcohol wipe. Because if you go in a circle, you're just going to smear what you're wiping off just right back. So just, this isn't no... Mr. Karate Kid. Hi, Tim.
Hi, Tim.
Recording. Just showing people how to do stuff that I don't know how to do. You know, so they can go ahead and live in misery like I do.
So they not know how to do what you don't know how to do?
Right. The more the merrier. It's their fault for watching. I'm back. Da-na-na-na-na-na-na. Oh boy. I just had to mess with my GoPro. Alright, so now, I'm sorry if this view is not very good, guys. Now we're going to take this and this that was sitting in warm water for at least 5 minutes. It was way longer than that. We're going to push. And look at that. It's mixing. It's got like a self-mixing too. It's kind of cool. Oh my gosh, you gotta push really hard. I'm probably gonna set this down and mix it up here. So that way you guys can see, and it's not as hard for me to do. I can use two hands. Yeah, you're definitely gonna wanna leave this in hot water because this is not easy. Oh, I guess I should have removed that thing. Oops. All right. Oh, come on. Are you serious? It's going to come out like this? This is dumb. This is going to take way too long. I do not like this. Did I do something wrong? No. I guess that's just how freaking hard it is. I'm squeezing as hard as I can. That's stupid. That's beyond stupid, if you want to know, and I don't see how there's enough in here to do all of this. Okay, whoever made this, he's a jack wagon. Are you kidding me? Okay, so what I went ahead and did was I cut that mixing tube off, and it came out a million times better, like the tip of it. But then it wasn't mixing as good, so I squirted it in there and I mixed it by hand really well, just to make sure, and I hope I have enough. The only thing about this is it seems sketch, you know? It's a little scary because you really, you're worried about losing it. Oh boy. Where did the hole go? That's what she said. There it is. Okay, before pushing too hard. Oh, sorry. You guys don't even get to see what I'm doing, do ya? Yeah, not that you really want to yet. Okay. My hands are already messy, so I'm gonna take my gloves off. Find your leveling device. I don't know where mine went. I'm so disorganized. Oh, here it is. My handed dandy. Level. Ghetto. Go towards the bubble to make it level. Push until yes, level. Just right about there. Go ahead and knock that off. Push until it squeezes out. Okay. Ah, yeah. Well, that's it. I seen one guy on YouTube take a board, and with the ratchet straps that are holding his board down, boat down, tighten it that way. I don't really have that option because this fish finder's here. I like that he did that, but I might be able to run one from the bottom up, something to, from here to here. Well, couldn't find a ratchet strap, but I did find some rope. Ooh, but I sure did cockeye it. Gosh darn it, I was just about ready to brag, like, look guys, no ratchet strap, no problem. Days. Go towards the bubble. Too much towards the bubble. Okay, that looks good. But anywho. Yeah. Just enough pressures on there. I went ahead and wrapped it around the trailer. Using a loop technique, wrapped it around the chair, and then just tied it off there. That'll work. Now I'm gonna start working on where I'm gonna mount it. This is where my five, oh, you can't see, can ya? Silly me. How about now? How about now?
No, okay. Bet you will if I put this one over that way.
Okay. Good enough. So this is where my five goes right now. So it doesn't look like a ton of room there for the other one. I'll figure it out. To be continued. All right, well, it's the next day. I did some shopping. I got the rest of the things I need to install the rest of this transducer and all this. Went ahead and bought some Gorilla glue. It's like a, it's stronger than silicone, but it's a type of silicone. I'm just a freak, like, it's bothering me, like, just thinking that, oh yeah, that's gonna hold good enough the way that it is. So just for peace of mind, I'm adding a bead, a silicone, or Gorilla Glue, all the way around. Just for some added insurance. It really came out the bottom though. Holy crap. Alright, that's good. I went ahead and attached this, made sure this was level. I just threw a level up here. Put the screws in, the transom saver, this piece. And now I'm just
tightening up the transducer. Okay, now what?
Now I guess the set screw, which is probably this thing, goes in there. Takes care of that.
In there and read the manual to make sure everything was right.
It looks right, sounds right.
For now, I'm just gonna put some black tape here. The one thing I didn't purchase out of everything else is these little, I don't know what you call them, wire holders. So that way I'm still able to run the wire without putting the wire holders on right now. I'm gonna do that, start running the wire up to the cockpit. And yeah, keep this train moving. Get out of here. Okay. I got it one piece at a time. Remember that song, guys? Stuck in my head. And that wire in there very good. Ended up using. You don't want to use something metal and accidentally puncture this wire and ruin the transducer wire. So I found a marker and just using the butt end of it. Push, and that's working really good.
Oh, I'm almost done running most of the wiring. I went ahead, tucked it up underneath there. And you have this power wire, which is two bare wires. It has a positive and a negative. And the manual says to run a 12 volt, 3 amp inline fuse. So I made sure I did that. That's just to protect it if you ever get like a power surge or a short circuit or something like that. So this will pop before it, you know, gets to your instrument. So all I gotta do now is figure out what to do with this jumbled mess. Find some hangers, throw the grass, the screens on, and that'll be it. So if you're doing this, the tools you'll need is some sort of extra glue adhesive if you want, a white, preferably a nice warm garage. You'll need some wire cutters, strippers, a set of these guys. This came together. I got it at O'Reilly's for like 10 bucks, pretty cheap. Here's the 3 amp mini fuses to run on that inline, a Phillips screwdriver. And really all you need is a drill, a Phillips screwdriver, a pair of wire cutters and stuff like that, some tape, a level, which, not that hard. It's definitely going to take you a while if it's your first time doing it. I'm sure somebody who's done this like a gazillion times, it's pretty easy for them. Me, it probably took me a total of, I would say, 2 hours. I'd say 2 hours. So I'm going to get that done. I'm still not technically done, but I'm pretty dang close. So I'm going to throw that stuff on there and make sure it all works. And yeah, I'll go over there again, guys. All right, bye-bye. You guys know what that is. That's the depth alarm. Let's go check it out. So I went ahead and took my windshield off and mounted this up here. We'll see how I like it before I go buy an $80 Ram mount. And then this is where I actually moved my 5. My 5 used to be up here, but the only thing that sucks is the old existing screw holes now. But that's my view. I'll have that and that one. Wires ran, went and got zip ties, went and got some of these guys to hold the sonars in place. Just ready to go. All I gotta do now is spend about an hour cleaning her up, getting it ready for tomorrow. Tomorrow's video will be another video. I'm gonna go out and try and get some catfish, see what I can't find on the river. But hey guys, let's get the outro done. Thanks for watching. Let me go over it again real quick. So I bought it, took it out of the package, went to Shields, bought all this at Shields. The mounting plate was like 30 bucks. Glued that on, sanded the area first, glued that on, made sure it was level, screwed the transducer itself to that transom saver, this block. Then I went ahead and ran the wire. If you have all the zip ties and stuff, it won't be take you as long. And a drill bit, make sure you get a drill bit because the screws will not go through this metal on their own. You'll strip them out unless you get like a bolt style head. Okay, so I did that, ran the wire, connected the power wire, put an inline fuse in, you know, got it all tucked away and looking good, and then just turned it on. I mean,
it is pretty easy to do yourself. The only true way to know. All right, GoPro camera died.
So I ran inside,
threw in a new battery.
So yeah, like I was saying, just make sure you get a drill bit, the wiring accessories, all the tools needed, drill bit, all that good stuff. You can do it. Hopefully this was a good enough how-to. I might have skipped a few steps and
show you guys.
I just wanted to let you guys know that I got a new freaking sonar and I am excited. Helix 7, can't wait to try it out.
The only true way to know if I did it right will be to get it out in the water, which I'm doing tomorrow. I'm gonna try and get some big old catfish in the boat. That's what I'm going after. So that'll be the next video I upload. Thanks for watching, guys. Please hit like, please hit subscribe. All that goodness. So until next time, do it yourself. Save some money.